name's Sam DeBenedetto. I live in Wanaque all my life. I work for the Wanaque Reservoir for 31 years, and I'm an amateur historian. I'll tell you a little bit about the reservoir. The reservoir was thought about in 1916. The actual construction was between 1926 and 1930. Construction on the headworks, which is down by the Wanaque River, next to Highland Ave on Ringwood Ave. That was probably one of the largest reconstruction areas that had to be taken care of. All the old paper mill buildings had to be ripped out, and the main dam had to be constructed right there. There's about five dams in all of the reservoir. They all had to be constructed. The Westbrook Bridge had to be constructed so people could get from Ringwood Ave to Westbrook and Stonetown Road. And the aqueduct, which goes from Stevens Ave all the way to Newark, or Bloomfield High School, where it goes into Newark's line. That all had to be constructed. The aqueduct consists of two 76-inch pipes, and they travel all the way from Stevens Ave to Newark. Also, the Ramapo pump station was built on the Ramapo River in Pumpkin Lakes, and that brought water into number 4 dam whenever they needed it. They actually have to keep 20 million gallons a day, and Wanaque needs 10 million to keep it alive, otherwise they get fined from the state. The water was treated at this time from 1930 all the way up to 1950. The water was treated on a little place called Limehouse Road, which is off of Riccio Drive. And it was a little 2x4 building with corrugated tin roof and walls. And they dumped the lime in there, they dumped the chlorine in there. And by the time it went all the way down the tube, it dissipated. There was no water filtering systems. It was just a treatment plant. That's all it was. Let's see, 1985 was the first water filter plant where all the stuff was put into the water to make it worth drinking, and it was filtered. It was the first filter plant the reservoir ever had. There was 10 large filters. They filtered the water before it went down the tube, just like your swimming pool filter works on your swimming pool, only on a larger scale. Not only was the filter plant built, but Monksville Dam was built in 1985, which housed a lot more water and is set up for hydroelectric power if they ever want to put it in. Monksville Dam sits between Wanaque Reservoir and Greenwood Lake. It's a 7-mile body of water between two other 7-mile bodies of water. Let's see. Also in 1985, the Wanaque South Pump Station was constructed. Wanaque South project was Monksville Dam. There was a aqueduct built from the headworks all the way to Ordell Reservoir, so they could pump all the way to Ordell Reservoir if they wanted to. And a pump station on Fairfield Road, which is on the Passaic River, which pumped Passaic River water up to Wanaque Reservoir. This definitely changed the quality of water. So the filters and everything, they weren't big enough. So in 1990, they built larger and bigger filters. They built like 10 more of them. They built a residual filter plant, because now that you have a filter plant facility, you had little particles of minerals, sand, chlorine dust, lime dust, just dirt in the water that they had to take out of the water. So they had to have a plant to store this stuff and get rid of it. Up to date, that's probably the size of the reservoir. After 2002, I know in the plans, they have plans to make the clear wells a lot larger. That holds the residual, water residual that's already been processed. Filters, they were going to put more filters in. like I say, Monksville is all set to go for hydroelectric power whenever they see fit. They want it done. And I'm sure it's just going to get larger, bigger, and better. It's never going to get smaller because you need more water every day. I think today, this week, they're pumping probably 160 million gallons a day. That's a lot of water from 1930 when they were probably pumping 70 million. So more people are living here. The need for water is a lot greater than it ever was. And they're just going to keep building and making it larger and larger. Otherwise, we won't have the water for the people.
Nature, in its ministry to man, is not only the material, but is also the process and the result. All the parts incessantly work into each other's hands for the profit of man. The wind sows the seed, the sun evaporates the sea. The wind blows the vapor to the field. The ice, on the other side of the planet, condenses rain on this. The rain feeds the plant feeds the animal. And thus the endless circulations of the divine charity nourish man. The useful arts are reproductions or new combinations by the wit of man, of the same natural benefactors. He no longer waits for favor and gales, but by means of steam he realizes the fable of Aeolus's bag, and carries the 2 and 30 winds in the boiler of his boat. To diminish friction, he paves the road with iron bars, and, mounting a coach with a shipload of men, animals, and merchandise behind him, he darts through the country, from town to town, like an eagle or a swallow through the air. By the aggregate of these aids, how is the face of the world changed? From the era of Noah to that of Napoleon. Ralph Waldo Emerson. The Wanaque Reservoir is an example of how man can use his wit to harness the power of nature without diminishing its beauty. It was once a regular town, with homes lining the streets and railways running through, connecting it to the rest of the world. However, this would all change in 1926, when construction began and the area was flooded to create what we now know as the Wanaque Reservoir. This colossal man-made reservoir supplies some of Wanaque's neighboring towns with drinking water by producing a whopping 160 million gallons of water per day. Ironically, the town for which the reservoir is named does not benefit from this output of water. The reservoir was not totally finished when the main construction was completed in 1930, but it has been a work in progress ever since. As mechanical and technical capabilities have become available, the reservoir has continued to grow and expand. One of the technical marvels created at the reservoir is the Monksville Dam. At the time of its construction, it was the only dam of its kind in America. From 1926 through the present, the Wanaque Reservoir has continued to grow and change with the times. Nothing is certain about the future growth and development of the reservoir. However, one thing is abundantly clear. What we now know as the Wanaque Reservoir today is only a fraction of what this man-made wonder has in store for the future. Amongst the beauty and awesome technical capabilities that characterize the Wanaque Reservoir is an element of the bizarre. On January 11, 1966, a police officer named Joe Sisko spotted what appeared to be a bright light hovering over the Wanaque Reservoir. More recently, Sisko has done interviews to help clear up some of the rumors surrounding that night, but he is still quoted as saying, "All I can say is that there was definitely something there, but I don't know what it was." The history of the Wanaque Reservoir is indeed as deep as the water it holds, and its importance to us now and in the future can only be measured by comparing it to the vast stretch of land it encompasses.